open the model you've just rigged in Mixamo, which I suggest you give a distinct name to avoid confusing it with your original model. In your scene, you'll see a preset camera, which doesn't pose any obstruction and can be kept as is. Your 3D model, which has a child modifier called skin, containing information about how bones influence the model's polygons. We don't have any animation on our timeline, and our scene is clean and ready to be saved in C4D format. Make sure to give it an appropriate name. Now, you'll need to create a null object to organize the bones for each of the animations you've downloaded, which will be part of your final set. I suggest numbering and titling them appropriately, starting with the first one, 0_origin. This will be the null object containing the hierarchy of bones with the original pose. So take your time and create a null object for each animation. It's important to maintain proper file and project organization to reach your goal without losing your mind. Next, locate your previously downloaded animations, select them all, and drag them directly into Cinema 4D. Make sure the Tracks checkbox under the Animation tab is turned on. Now, go through them one by one, take a look, and make sure each one arrived in good condition. In my case, I forgot to export some of the Mixamo animations without skin, so the files were a bit heavier. But since I only need the bone information, I can remove the excess objects and move on. So, once you're sure you have all the animations in order, you can go to each scene, copy the bones from the parent object, go to your master scene, paste them, drag them into their respective null objects, and turn off the object's visibility. Do the same for each animation. In this case, I need two different knockdowns and two different stand-ups since my character is a zombie that probably gets up after being knocked down. So I'm figuring out which animations correspond and organizing them accordingly. Our model still hasn't adopted the animations we've downloaded, but we're all set to assign the motion, and we'll do that in the next lesson. Once you're done, remember to save your master project.